afternoon. The braid that connects Robert Jackson and Chautauqua Institution is a thick strand of many twines, and I will be speaking about that tomorrow afternoon. But one particular strand in that weaving pertains to our featured speaker this afternoon, E. Barrett Prettyman. As Greg mentioned, Barrett Prettyman began to clerk for Justice Jackson in the summer of 1953 and served through a full year as the justice's only law clerk. The boss was so satisfied with the law clerk's assistance that during that year he asked him to stay on for a second year, and Mr. Prettyman agreed, and they both look forward to a second year together. Alas, that was not to be, at least not very long. Indeed, during the first year, the dark clouds gathered as Justice Jackson, in March of 1954, suffered a very serious heart attack. He then spent 7 weeks in the hospital. He left the hospital only for the momentous occasion that Mr. Prettyman will be speaking about, the Brown decision. And then during the summer of 1954, Justice Jackson somewhat obeyed but mostly disregarded his doctor's advice. The doctor told Jackson that in the primitive understandings of 1954 cardiology, he needed to cut back. He needed to travel less. He needed to slow down. He needed to restrict extracurricular activities. Perhaps some more exercise and a little dietary adjustment would have benefited him too. Jackson processed all of that and decided, I think, almost explicitly that 62 years in that time and place was a good full run for a man. He'd already had that. He was going to keep living the way he liked to live. And if the candle went out, the candle would go out. And it did, only months later, October 9, 1954. Sensing that his strategic disregard for medical advice meant time was short, Jackson spent that summer of 1954 literally returning to every place that he loved that had been part of forming it in his life. And so in July of 1954, he and his wife Irene drove from Washington north and stopped in Frewsburg and stayed with his sister. And then on the first day of July, came here to Chautauqua Institution. Jackson was not speaking on that occasion. He was just visiting the grounds. He was strolling. And he was writing a postcard. It's a postcard of Norton, a hall down not too many baseball throws from here that you know well, that he addressed to his law clerk, Barrett Prettyman. He wrote on the back a note that just said, this is a place that you talk about that you've never gotten a chance to see, and I wanted to send this to you, and keep up the good work. Prettyman was back in chambers working on what were called cert memos through most of that summer term. Then Jackson went fishing with friends up above Thousand Islands in Canadian waters, and he sent a postcard from there to Barrett Prettyman. Then he returned to Washington, and then he went on a trip to California, to the Bohemian Grove, where he spent 2 weeks in every summer during the last 8 years of his life. And he sent a postcard from there to Barrett Prettyman. It says, I think, something about, of course, the boss staying in contact with the office and the staff of one, perhaps. But more than that, it says something substantive about the personal relationship and tie that Robert Jackson, Supreme Court Justice, age 62, and Barrett Prettyman, young law school graduate, one clerkship year done and a second beginning, had at that point in time. This was a special partnership, a team of, I think, high mutual regard and affection, and it had this Chautauqua place as part of its tangible imprint. I'm sure Barrett Prettyman didn't think much of a glimpse of Norton Hall in the summer of 1954. It was just a card from the boss, but I dare say that we all understand that for Chautauquans, Robert Jackson was very much a Chautauquan. That was something from deep inside him. So it's my pleasure to introduce Justice Jackson's final law clerk and our speaker this afternoon, E. Barrett Prettyman, Jr.